Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us again. This week, we're going to be assigning each other book challenges for the upcoming year. Hannah and I were trying to figure out what we wanted to do for a video that was kind of a fun way to end the year. And we want to really encourage our reading habits in the new year. Me especially, because I just feel like I don't read that much and I want that to change. So we have called this like a reading challenge, and that Hannah is going to assign some books for me to help me try and like establish a habit. And then I am giving Hannah a list of books that I think that she'll really connect with. And I made it kind of even, which will be explained as I go on, but I think it'll be a nice way for her to kind of expand her current reading habit, because she's already a lot better
I am quite an avid reader.
Yeah.
So I'm curious to see what you've assigned, because Emma has acknowledged that she would like to increase the amount of time she spends with books and reading. I wanted to do something that was a bit of a challenge while also being very attainable and accessible. So we want to challenge ourselves, but we want to make sure that we're successful in establishing that habit.
I'm a dumb dumb. I'm dumber than a box of rocks.
Dumber than a box of rocks. Because Emma has outlined one of her goals as increasing the amount that she reads.
Oh, you said that so nicely. Because it's like so euphemistic to like, she doesn't read, dumb ho.
Oh my god. No. I thought it would be nice and manageable to do a book a month. So 12 books total in a year. Does that sound reasonable to you?
We'll see, won't we? We'll come back and we'll do a follow-up video after the year's up and see if we succeeded in reading all of these books.
Without further ado, here is the list, in no particular order, of books that I'm assigning for Emma to read over her 12 months. Jane Eyre.
Yes, I want to read that.
Yeah, I put that on the list because I know that she's been wanting to read it for quite a while now.
Yeah.
Fun Home. This is a graphic novel. I thought it would be fun to like switch it up. Like Water for Chocolate.
Ooh.
This one you've read before, but I wanted you to revisit it.
Okay.
A Farewell to Arms.
Okay. That makes sense too. And I read A Farewell to Arms in high school and I absolutely hated it. So we'll see how I feel about it this time around.
And I think this is the book that Bradley Cooper's character reads in Silver Linings Playbook, and he gets to the end and he goes, "What the?" And he closes it and throws it out the window, like breaks the window.
What the?
So anyway, we'll see if it has the same effect as High School Emma and then and Bradley Cooper movie. Our fifth one, I have another graphic novel, Mouse.
Okay. I've read some of that, but I would like to read the rest of it.
On a different note, I also have Little Women on the list.
Okay.
Now, this is something that we've read before and we enjoy. If I were doing it, I would put it close to Christmas time.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking.
Yeah, for obvious reasons.
Yeah.
Now, I put this one on here because I haven't read it.
Okay.
It's The Wind in the Willows.
Okay.
So it's Mr. Toad and everything. Yeah. And this is more of maybe like a children's book. The other one is Wild. Emma loves the West. And then also maybe like shake things up. So novels and some graphic novels, some children's books sprinkled in here and there. And then maybe some nonfiction as well. I also put Stardust.
Yay!
Yeah.
I do want to read that.
I know. I was thinking about all the Neil Gaiman's. All the Neil Gaiman. There are
so many of them.
I was thinking about all of his body of work. I know you listen to Graveyard Book.
By the way, that is a children's book, which
go off.
Maybe as far as Neil Gaiman goes, I need to stick to the children's books because like that was a lot for me.
I did almost put Coraline. I almost put Coraline, but I was like, oh, I don't want to freak her out too bad. But I heard that Stardust, the book, is very, very different from the movie. But I know that we do like the movie and you like the movie and you have said it multiple times. Oh, I really should pick up Stardust.
Yeah.
So I think this year you're going to pick it up. I challenge you.
All right.
Another autobiographical / memoir is I Know Where the Caged Bird Sings.
Ah, nice.
Because you've not read this, right?
I don't think so.
Yeah. Metamorphosis.
Ooh.
That way you can throw out Kafka-esque and have something to back it up. That's it.
That's the essence.
Rounding it out with a nice even 12 is a room of one's own.
Ooh.
How are you feeling about this list and about the number 12?
Yeah.
And that the 12 are these books?
Well, that was kind of the number that I was thinking about myself. Like when I was thinking of like, okay, what kind of goal do I want to set as far as reading in the new year? And it was a book a month, which I know for some people is like painfully slow, but for me that felt good, and I'm happy to like ramp it up if I'm feeling really confident with that later on, but it's a good place for me to start. Okay, my turn. This is a list of books evenly split by male and female identifying authors, and this is in no particular order. Hannah can read these books whenever she likes, but I just want her to read these so that she can give me her thoughts on them. Because these are also mostly books that I would like to read as well. So the first book is going to be no surprise whatsoever to Hannah. I wanted to get it for Christmas, but I had some... I wanted to get this book for her for Christmas, but I could not find it in time.
It's not the Bible.
It's not the Bible. Sorry, Mom.
Sorry, Mom.
It is The Secret History by Donna Tartt.
It's very big in the dark academia scene.
Yeah.
So, looking forward to reading it and,
yeah.
And being able to be like, sit at the cool kids table.
Yeah.
Anyway, all right, cool.
Next is Lud in the Mist by Hope Mirrlees. This, I don't know if you've heard of before.
Uh-uh.
Okay. So, this is like a fantasy novel that is pre-Tolkien. He's like acknowledged mostly with like pioneering that genre. I've heard about this book recently and I go, ooh. That's gonna be a good book for us to read. Again, these are in no particular order though. It's just next on what I've written down. Fledgling by Octavia Butler.
Nice. That's the vampire one, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
This next one is also one we haven't read. Story, really quickly. Hannah and I were doing some local hiking and we ran into this woman and we talked with her for a little bit. Do you remember this?
The one who used to be a gym teacher?
Yeah.
That one?
Yeah.
I don't remember the book yet.
Well, it's not the book, it's the name of the author.
Okay.
But I told myself, I was like, I will remember this person's name. The author is Molly Crabapple. This was like the woman's daughter-in-law or something, I think. I chose Drawing Blood. It is a memoir.
Okay.
So we both actually got a memoir in there. Next is an author that Hannah likes and wants to dive into a little bit more.
Ooh.
Any guesses?
All right. It could be Neil Gaiman, or it could be, is it Anne Rice?
No.
Okay. Is it Agatha Christie?
No.
Is it Terry Pratchett?
No, but he's on her list. I'll just say it.
Oh no, I'm so sorry.
It's Ursula K. Le Guin.
Oh, Ursula Le Guin! Yes! Every thought has left my brain. That's how excited I am to read Ursula.
It's The Dispossessed.
The Dispossessed. Ursula Le Guin.
Yeah.
The Dispossessed.
Okay, the next book is by one of our professors.
Dr. Noyes!
No.
Amy!
Yeah. So it's The Sadness of Spirits.
Okay, cool.
I don't know. I just feel like you guys...
Yeah, is that the one that she read from? Where? Okay, yeah.
Cool.
She's just so interesting, so I'm glad you put that on there.
Next is an author that you've read before. We've both read. It's Piranesi by Susanna Clarke.
I think it's The Fairies. The Fairies are just... Yeah.
This one is Agnes Grey by Anne Bronte.
Nice. I've not read any Anne Bronte.
Yeah.
We've got the other two. It'd be nice to get the third in.
Yeah, that's exactly what I thought. Basically, all of these are books that I want Hannah to read first.
I will be the guinea pig.
It's okay. Interview with the Vampire.
Yeah.
We're moving over to the men.
To the men.
First one, big book, Crime and Punishment.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Okay.
Hannah wanted a challenge.
All right.
Here's her challenge coming in. Well, and I threw in another big book.
Challenge accepted.
Another classic. Big
Anna Karenina.
Book. Yes.
Oh. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. I do like big books, and I cannot
and
lie.
I cannot lie. Next up, you've already guessed the author. It's Terry Pratchett.
Okay.
Guards. This one, I think, is part of like a really large series, And I thought that might be kind of fun, that if you jive with it, you can like spend a long time in the world and with the characters. Next is a book that I've read and it's always kind of stuck with me. And I want Hannah to read it. I had to read it in high school.
The Road.
I kind of want to revisit it again, but through Hannah's eyes.
And then maybe based on what I say, maybe you will Hannah's or won't experience, pick it back up again?
Yeah.
Okay.
Next is an author that our creative writing professors talked a lot about.
Why did you just sound like a pirate? That are. Or maybe an Irishman. That are.
of course, it's when I'm not trying. This one is Italo Calvino. Invisible Cities is the one I chose for you to read. Next is a book I know Hannah's been wanting to read.
What number are we on?
It's 18 books total.
I thought you said 16.
Yeah, I added two just in the thing because I was thinking about them. And then the more I thought about it, I was like, yeah, I'm going to throw them in there. It is Slaughterhouse-Five. By Kurt Vonnegut.
You know, honestly, I've never read any Kurt Vonnegut. Yeah. And I think that is probably...
Yeah, and I know you want to, so you have to do it now for this challenge. We have Coraline by Neil Gaiman.
How interesting.
Because I want you to read it and be like, how scary is this really?
Okay. I almost put the Sandman on yours, but I was like, no, I don't think she can take the illustrations for some of these things. Like, they are gnarly. Sweet. Coraline.
Yeah.
That's been on my personal list. I just haven't picked it up yet. I will have to.
Next is an author that our mom really likes. We were just talking about it recently.
Oh, it's Canary Row.
Yeah, okay. It is.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. That's Steinbeck.
Yeah.
Cool. I've only read The Moon Is Down, and I don't really remember it. Okay. It'd be good to read some more Steinbeck. That's another, you know, classic one. I like that you didn't go for classic Steinbeck, Grapes of Wrath.
I didn't want to.
So I like that. No, I like it. I think that's a good choice.
The last one, we were very intrigued by the opening line. Lolita!
I almost put Lolita on yours, but then I saved it.
It's basically a guessing game with Sam.
That actually is really
gave
fun.
Her a bunch of hints.
Yeah, that was a fun little game.
So that was everything.
Thanks, sis. I love all my books that you've picked out. I'm very nervous to read all of them, though. Especially the bigger, you know, Russian ones.
We were coming up with our lists independently, and then Hannah was like, well, it's a challenge, right? And I was like,
okay.
Oh, it's a challenge.
And then I was like, well, okay. You want a challenge.
She like cracked her knuckles and everything.
I'll give you a challenge. Turned into an 18 book challenge. Here you go.
Nice. Thank you so much for spending time with us. We'll see you again next time.
Be kind to each other and be kind to yourself. Thanks for watching, y'all. Bye.
Bye.